People been in my email talking about team driving. So this is what I basically came up with. Some people already have a year experience under their belt and have their certifications already, you know what I mean? So if you are interested in team driving, send me an email. Even if you're under a year, just let me know that you're under a year. And then what I basically do with your consent, I'll send your number to the other person, and then you guys could both apply, and you guys could probably go from there, you know what I mean? That's a good way to find a teammate. So you guys can start at VL, because it seems like either, they're not even a lease. They don't even seem like they want to hire people for leasing. That they want owner-operators. That's the last thing somebody told me. So what I mean? So it's mostly like they want team drivers or owner operator. So you know, send me an email with your name and your number and all that stuff, and if you have all your endorsements, your driving record is clean, and the level of experience that you got, send it to the email. And by sending me the email, I'm assuming that you're giving me consent to send your number to somebody else to like help you guys to pair up, you know what I mean? So this way everybody can eat. See what I mean? I was just at VL recently. I went to the terminal to pick up my tablet. I'm gonna drop that clip right here, because I'm gonna show you guys the trucks that they got, and what I basically said about those trucks that they had. They have new 2020 Freightliners, Cascadia, that are team trucks. So check the clip out right here. Right now, y'all can barely see because it's like 4 o'clock in the morning. But I stopped by here to pick my tablet up and shit. I'm gonna give y'all some game real quick. These are the new 2020 Freightliners, 2020 or 2019 Freightliners. If y'all come here as a company driver and y'all get one of these right here, right off the bat, you should go leasing. Don't even ask no question, because they give these to company drivers. I met company drivers here that have these, you know what I mean? So you get a brand new truck, but they usually save the brand new trucks for like team driving, you know what I mean? That's a Volvo 860 right there. Somebody coming. Alright, so y'all basically see what I was talking about, you know what I mean? Them things nice, and you can still see they're still getting in trucks. Because some of these trucks that they literally just came off the auction. The paper is still on the thing, you know what I mean, on the window. So the next thing I wanted to talk about real quick was like I advise some of y'all to go in the comment section and see some of these comments that people leave on some of my videos, you know what I mean? Two things I'm gonna mention, a few comments that caught my eye the other day. I did two videos the other day. One guy commented and said, I spend a lot of time on YouTube educating idiots, and I should spend more time driving, and I wouldn't be late and all that stuff. All right, my response to that, bro, firstly, I'm not educating idiots, you know what I mean? I made my channel so I can help people and give people information that nobody else would give them, you know what I mean? So I'm not educating idiots. You can't call people idiots. My subscribers and the viewers, the people that view my videos, they're not idiots. Cause you can't even say that, because I've seen you commented on plenty of my videos before. Is what I mean. So that means you view my videos. Are you saying that you're an idiot also? Is that what you're saying? So I don't think that you should say people are idiots. I spend a lot of time educating idiots. Don't say that. The same guy also talked about the video that I made about the guy that owned the three trucks at VL Trucking. You know what I mean? He said those three trucks are Volvos and I could get those trucks in Chicago for like $6,000. Bro, I don't care if it could be a Volvo, a Freightliner, a Peterbilt, a Kenworth, a Mack. It doesn't matter, bro. He has three trucks at VLs. That's three streams of income. That's what's important. You know what I mean? It doesn't matter if he paid $5,000 or $5 or $50,000. The guy said he has three trucks. Shout out to him. That's motivation for somebody. You know what I mean? I had in mind a few things that I wanted to do here at VL. And a few things, you know what I mean? But I never thought about like having three trucks at VL, you know what I mean? I never thought of that. So that's motivation for somebody. You can't criticize them and say, yeah, three Volvos or whatever the case. Now you work here at VL. You said your equipment is paid off like 110K or whatever the case is. Your truck and trailer is all paid off. So shout out to you. You work here at VL. You say you've been driving for 5 years. VL is home for you, so you know VL is, you know, that is good. But you can't say people are idiots and you can't criticize the guy if he has 3 Volvos or whatever the case is. I just said the guy had 3 trucks. Okay. Next one I wanted to talk about real quick. I did a video talking about being late to the shipper. This guy said he watched my videos ever since I was at Trends. So shout out to you. You've been watching from day one. But he said he felt the need to comment this time because all he heard was basically I was whining about... he said he don't see why I'm whining about this and that, and he disagree because why do I expect the shippers to bend over for me after being late or whatever the case is. You first thing I said, you must not be a truck driver to be saying that. He said he drives and all that stuff, but you guys know what I'm talking about. Shippers and receivers, you must do local work or something, bro, or you must never done OTR to understand what I'm saying. You see what I mean? Who feels it knows it. I know what I go through, shippers and receivers. Why do you think a lot of people don't even do reefer? Because you sit in the docks for so long sometimes. You know what I mean? There's been times where I work at Trans Am where I remember I got this load from Cargill that was going to one of the Walmarts. I got there on time and everything. I sat in the dock for 7 hours, bro. They told me it was like 500, I think it was 1,000 cases, and they have to hand count all 1,000 cases. I sat in the door for 7 hours and you're not paid for that time. That's basically what I'm saying. I'm sharing my experience. It's what I mean. So you can't say, and the fact that I got there late, yes, I got there late, I paid the late fee, they still took over 4.5 hours to unload the truck. That's a long time to be sitting in the dock, and it's a chain reaction because one thing leads to the other, you know what I mean? So like, I don't see how you could make a comment like that and still think that that makes sense or whatever the case is, eh? But shout out to you. Everybody is entitled to your own opinion. So some of the time, bro, y'all can pop in the comment section, leave your views and your thoughts and all that stuff. Because I'm not the type of person where I like to learn, you know what I mean? And no matter how much I know, I'm not the type of person, oh, I can't take this correction, or you can't tell me this. I'm not that type of person, you know what I mean? So if I say something, you disagree with it, and I see what you're saying, it makes sense, then yeah, you know what I mean, I'm gonna accept it or whatever. And shout out to the other dude that basically said you know, made a comment and I said the guru in trucking said there's not a lot of ways to go about this or whatever the case is, not a lot of ways to skin the cat, pretty much. He said basically what he was referring to was newer drivers, which, you know, is true, is actually right. But you gotta also think about it, like the fact that like a company like this now, they will hire you fresh out of CDL school, put you with a driver that already has experience and let you train them. Depending on the agreement that you have with the driver, with the experience, based on what you're paid. Let's say you take somebody fresh out of school. Let's say you had a son or your wife or somebody, and you decided to just go half and half on all the revenue to the truck, then basically you're gonna start fresh out of school and be making thousands, you know what I mean? But he's actually right when he said there's not a lot of ways for you to do it, because the traditional way is to go to a mega carrier and you're not really gonna make much money. You're gonna make $500-$600 a week, you know what I mean? So he's actually right. But what I'm basically getting to, you guys can pop in the comment section. There's a lot of information in some of these comment sections on the videos, and I'm gonna leave the description in to via, you know what, speaking of, before I even end this video, let's talk about this too, because I see a lot of people on different channels criticizing and saying, oh, because like there's so much hate with VL, even if in recent times, bro. There's so much hate, so many different YouTubers talking about VL, and like I said, you can know when somebody's hating and when somebody's giving like constructive criticism, and when somebody, but like you can know, low-key know who feels some type of way that, you know, drivers are making bread, because that's what it's all about, bro, the money, you know what I mean? I watched this video the other day. This guy was saying some of these drivers are just doing this for the referral. Okay, let me talk about that. Let me step on that real quick. I watched this video, trucking with Tay, you know what I mean, that flatbed guy that's been doing his thing. He bought his own truck. I've been watching his channel for a little time now, but he had a video one a long time ago where he said, how do you make $100,000 in your first year of trucking? And he basically said, you should, if this is how you make $100,000 in your first year of trucking, if the company has bonuses, try to utilize all the bonus. If they have a safety bonus, try to stay in the safety criteria so you can get the bonus. If they have a fuel bonus, do whatever they say to get the fuel bonus. If they have a home time bonus for you to stay out a certain time for you to get the bonus, do that. If they have a referral bonus, use it up, bro. There's nothing wrong with getting referrals. I can understand where they're saying, like, if you went to a messed up company and you're just telling drivers to, hey, you know, the company tell you, okay, every driver you get over here, we give you this amount of money. And, you know, they were just out here just misleading people and sending them, telling people all kind of BS. And cause so far, like, all the YouTubers that I see do videos on YouTube, bro, they're not telling any lies, you know what I mean? They're speaking all facts, you know what I mean? And I fall in the category of telling people about this company. If there wasn't a referral, would I tell people about the company? Of course, I'd still tell people about the company. I work at Transam for a whole year. I never got a referral bonus. I never tripped about it or anything. The referral bonus is not the point of my channel. You see what I mean? The point of my channel is to help people and give people the information that nobody else would give them. You know what I mean? So it would be nice if I got a referral. It would be nice, you know what I mean? Because if you, it takes nothing out of you for you to use the truck or my name as a referral and say, because you got the information from a channel, it takes nothing, you know what I mean? And you can help somebody else by when you come here, if you know somebody else that, because this is the thing, like, I was in a situation before, you know what I mean? I was making the 500 to 400 bucks a week, and like, I know what it's like, you know what I mean? I felt like times that I just, you know, just call it a day and just give this up, and you know what I mean, I should just go back to cooking, because I was making way more when I was working in the kitchen, you know what I mean? So I know the feeling. So if I can put information out there that's going to help somebody that was in the same situation that I am in, then basically I'm going to do that, bro, you know what I mean? How could you get mad at a YouTuber for using up the referrals, bro? You can't get mad at people because they're doing YouTube, they're putting out videos, and they're gaining revenues from this, and they're, it's vice versa, they're doing the same thing. They're only criticizing, trying to bring down somebody else doing something, you know what I mean? And people want to see you do good, bro, but some people won't want to see you doing better than them, you know what I mean? Men lie, women lie, but the numbers don't lie. I have two interesting videos that I'm gonna drop soon, speaking about numbers, and I'm gonna show you guys some things to give you guys some motivation. You can't listen to everybody, you know what I mean? That's what that's one thing I say, and that's why I stopped listening to a lot of channels, because I'm gonna share another quick example with you guys. One time, before I came to VL, I was doing some research on 1099, because I do my own research and all that stuff. And I was watching this video of this guy, right? He's this big YouTuber. And he was basically talking about 1099, how much is it, is a scam. You can't be a company driver as a 1099, all this stuff. 1099 this, 1099 is bad, 1090. Fast forward 2-3 years, because this video is like 2-3 years ago. Fast forward, we're in 2020. This guy now owns a fleet of trucks. You see what I mean? And he's hiring drivers. What kind of drivers is this guy hiring? 1099 drivers. But the same guy was criticizing 2 years ago, you shouldn't do 1099, you shouldn't do, you can't listen to all these people, bro. Especially if they've never done it before. I'm telling you, dog, you gotta know for yourself, and people gotta have a mind for their own to pick sense out of nonsense too. You know what I mean? So shout out to everybody that's been coming to the coming to VL. I'm trying to get, you know, make something better out of their trucking career. I'm no cheerleader for this company, because I'm not loyal to any company. Let's make that clear right now. Me personally, I'm not loyal to any company. If I'm loyal to a company, I'm loyal to my LLC, which is YSE Transport, you know what I mean? Because these companies, they will push you out within like nothing, you know what I mean? The point of it is, you know, I'm able to make something of myself here. I'm able to do some stuff, what I've always wanted to do, with the revenue that I can make, you know what I mean, from here. And it's a better opportunity. It's not the best company, it's not perfect. Ain't nobody saying VL trucking is perfect, you know what I mean? Everywhere has their flaws, bro. Everywhere you go has their flaws. VL has their ups and downs just the same. But I feel like what most of these YouTubers are trying to tell you guys is that you can make a lot of money. The hands down, you can make a lot of money with VL, you know what I mean? Even though it's 1099, let's just make that clear. But you, even after deducting your taxes and setting aside some for your taxes, you still make a lot of money with VL trucking. So I'm going to leave a link in the description to the company's website, you know what I mean? And I'm also going to leave my referral code, because I know some of y'all watching this and y'all still talking about this referral code bullshit or whatever the case is. I'm going to leave my referral there. you guys reach to the email, let me know about the team, if you guys are interested in team driving, and I'll see what I can do to help somebody out. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Look out for the next two videos, because I'm telling you, those ones are going to be good. I'll see you guys in the next video.